Recall that the bag of words model converts text data into numeric vector space representations. It represents a document based on the frequency of the terms. A document term matrix, or term document matrix, is a matrix that describes the frequency of terms that occur in a collection of documents. Each row corresponds to a document, so the resulting matrix is useful for comparing documents to each other. However, as you know, it is usually both very high-dimensional and sparse. It contains many zeros entries because most documents only contain a small fraction of the overall vocabulary, and it cannot capture the latent or underlying structure or even summarize document content. Latent themes came from the idea that documents are actually governed by some hidden or latent variables that we're not observing. These variables represent the meaning or semantic of the document. The process of learning, recognizing, and extracting hidden topics across a collection of documents is called topic modeling, which is very useful for discovery of potentially insightful themes in customer reviews, news articles, legal contracts, and so forth. All topic models are based on the same basic assumption. Each document consists of a mixture of topics, and each topic consists of a collection of words. There are several models that perform topic modeling: latent semantic indexing, probabilistic latent semantic analysis, latent Dirichlet allocation, and a newer model, LDL plus Word2Vec combine. Let's start with latent semantic indexing, LSI, also called latent semantic analysis, LSA. It is one of the foundational techniques in topic modeling. It captures the semantic document term relationship by reducing dimensionality of the word space, and it does it by matrix decomposition. Recall that we can represent collection of document as DTM or TDM. Let's look at term document matrix. Our rows are our terms, and the columns are documents. Of course, alternatively, we have rows as the documents and the columns as the terms. TDM decomposition is performed using single value decomposition, SVD, which find the best approximation of the original data points using fewer dimensions, and identify in order dimensions along with data points that exhibit most variation. So SVD split a matrix into three smaller matrices that when multiply equivalent to the original matrix. So if A is a term document matrix, then U is the left singular vector of words, sigma is the matrix with weight value on the diagonal, and V is the right singular vector of documents. Truncated SVD reduces dimensionality by selecting only the k largest singular values and only keeping the first k columns of U and V. In this case, we can say that k is hyperparameter that we can select and adjust to reflect the number of topics that we want to find. LSA decomposition can be interpreted as follows. One matrix represents the relation between documents and topics. The diagonal matrix scales the topic by their corpus strength, or topic strength. And the third matrix models the term-topic relationship. To illustrate the application for LSI, we'll be using the BBC articles, data provided by Stefan Jansson, in his book Machine Learning for Algorithmic Trading. This dataset comes with 2,225 news articles in five categories: business, entertainment, politics, sports, and tech. And we will create a data frame with three columns: category, heading, article. Then we'll vectorize data using TF-IDF vectorizer, which is strongly recommended for topic modeling. So with TF-IDF vectorizer, we obtain weighted DTM count, and of course filter our words that appear in less than 1% and more than 25% of the documents, as well as we filter out the generic stop words. And so we have a very sparse matrix vocabulary of around 2,900 words. We use scikit-learn truncated SVD class, and we'll compute 5 topics just to match our 5 categories. We can combine now TF-IDF and SVD model, and then we'll fit and apply to documents. The transform method project documents into the new topic space that is the result of reducing dimensionality for our document vectors. And by taking the average topic weight per category, we can now project the average topic assignment per category into just 2-dimensional space. We can also display the words that are most closely associated with each topic, of course in absolute terms, and a topic appear to capture some semantic information. As you can see in topic 4, words film, award, Oscar appear. It sounds like entertainment. The strength of LSI include the removal of noise and dimensionality reduction. And it does capture some semantic aspect, as you've seen. Another advantage, it does not require knowledge of the document language, and we can easily compare documents. However, there is a weakness. The results of LSI difficult to interpret, because as you can see, topics are word vectors with both positive and negative directions. There's also no underlying model with evaluation of fit, and there's no test for selecting the number of dimension a topic to use. Here we used 5 just because we have 5 categories in our articles. Probabilistic latent semantic analysis, or PLSA, is the next version of topic modeling. It utilizes probabilistic method instead of singular value decomposition. It models probability word W appearing in the document D as a mixture of conditionally independent multinormal distribution that involve topics. And the core idea is to find a probabilistic model with latent topics that can generate the data we observe in our document term matrix. The number of topics is our hyperparameter that we choose prior to training. And of course, it is not learned from the data. Let's look at this plate notation here. It describes the statistical dependency in our probabilistic model. Probability of document is observed and determined from a corpus. Probability of a topic given a document and the probability of a word given the topic are not observed. So this shaded area represents a hidden topic distribution. Both conditional probabilities are modeled as multinormal distributions and can be trained via expectation maximization algorithm EM, which determines parameter estimates for a model that depends on those latent variables. The benefit of using this probability model is that now we can compare models by evaluating the probability they assign to new documents. Let's look at PLSA implementation. In fact, it is equivalent to non-negative matrix factorization, NMF, using Kullback-Leibler divergence objective. So we will be using scikit-learn NMF decomposition, but we will assign a beta loss as Kullback-Leibler. And we will use the same number of topics as previously, with N component is set to 5. Then we apply our pipeline with vectorizer and our NMF model on training set. Now, due to the probabilistic nature, PLSA model produces only positive topic weights, which results in more straightforward topic category relationship for the test and training sets. As you can see in the figure on the left, each news article category is represented with a topic assignment. For example, entertainment category is most directly associated with topic 4 in red. In figure on your right, we can see the topic 4 includes words such as film star, award, and so forth, which are in fact related to entertainment industry. So the strength of this model, in fact, is that we can now compare performance of different models, and the results have a clear probabilistic interpretation. The weakness of it is that PLSA increases computational complexity compared to LSI, and it does not yield a generative model for new documents because it takes them as a given. Which brings us to our next model, latent Dirichlet allocation, LDA. This model extends PLSA by adding a generative process for topics. In fact, it is the most popular topic model because it tends to produce meaningful topics, and it is a hierarchical Bayesian model, which assumes topics are probability distribution over words, and documents are distributions over topics. And the model assumes also that the topics follow a sparse Dirichlet distribution. We can also use a variance for LDL, which could include metadata, for example, authors, the articles, or even image data. Recall in PLSA we sample a document, then a topic based on the document, then a word based on that topic. In LDL model, we draw a random sample with topic distribution from a Dirichlet distribution, alpha. And this topic distribution comes from a particular document. The topic distribution is annotated as theta. From theta, we select a particular topic, z, which is based on this distribution. Next, we have another Dirichlet allocation distribution, beta, and we select a random sample representing a word distribution of the topic z. And this word distribution is annotated as phi. From phi, we choose the word w. LDL typically works better than PLCA because it can generalize to new documents. In PLSA, the document probability is fixed point in dataset. In LDL, dataset serves as training data for Dirichlet distribution of document topic distributions. To train our data on LDL model, we use scikit-learn decomposition latent Dirichlet allocation class with 5 topics. And again, we will use our pipeline with vectorizer and LDL model. To visualize the results, we will be using PyLDLVs, which is a Python library for interactive topic model visualization. And to visualize it, in fact, you need to provide topic term or document term distribution and basic information about your corpus and the model that you used. And the main function is prepare function, and it will transform your data into the format needed for the visualization. And then the package extract information from a fitted LDL topic model to create interactive web-based visualization.